Hi, my name is Safia Costes. I am an investigator in the laboratory of the Professor Peter Butler at the University of California, Los Angeles. The study I will be presenting was conducted with my colleague, Jacqueline Rivera, who is a co-first author on the paper published in the Journal of Clinical Investigation. So the purpose of our study was to understand what leads to beta cell dysfunction and death and causes type 2 diabetes. The islet in type 2 diabetes is characterized by a deficit in beta cells stained in brown and amyloid deposits that derive from islet amyloid polypeptide or IAPP. IAPP is co-expressed and co-secreted with insulin by pancreatic beta cells. And as you can see here, IAPP contains an amyloidogenic region in red that is conserved between human, monkey, and cat. In contrast, rodent IAPP is non-toxic and non-amyloidogenic, and these species do not develop diabetes spontaneously. However, if we overexpress human IPP in the beta cells of rodents, this leads to an islet pathology that is comparable to that of human subjects with type 2 diabetes, as you can see here. In addition to extracellular IPP deposits that are rather inert, findings in our laboratory show that IPP toxic oligomers are present intracellularly in beta cells of human subjects with type 2 diabetes, as you can see here on this electron microscopy image. So among the pathways involved in IAPP toxicity in beta cells that are represented here, we recently showed that amyloidogenic IAPP leads to an alteration of the pathways of protein clearance known as the ubiquitin proteasome system and the autophagy pathway. However, it remains unclear whether these pathways are involved in IAPP clearance in beta cells. In this study, we focused on the autophagy pathway, which is a bulk degradative process involved in the degradation of polyubiquitinated protein, aggregated proteins, or damaged organelles. In this pathway, P62 is a key player. P62 is a scaffold protein that allows the degradation of the targeted protein through the lysosomal degradation. So in this study, we investigated whether IAPP clearance is mediated through this mechanism and addressed the following hypothesis. So first, we hypothesized that the autophagy-dependent degradation of IAPP is mediated by P62. Second, we hypothesized that under conditions of increased human IAPP expression, P62 buffers toxicity by forming inert intracellular inclusions. And finally, we hypothesized that concurrent loss of autophagy and increased human IAPP expression leads to beta cell deterioration and diabetes. To address the first hypothesis, we used pancreatic beta cells that we treated with stimulator of autophagy, rapamycin, or lysosomal inhibitors and followed IAPP intracellular levels. And as you can see here on this immunoblot, rapamycin treatment leads to a decrease in IAPP protein levels. In contrast, lysosomal inhibitor treatment leads to an accumulation of IAPP. So this data show that IAPP is degraded by an autophagy lysosomal dependent degradation. We then investigated whether IAPP degradation is mediated by P62. To answer that question, we evaluated by immunoprecipitation the interaction between IAPP and P62 in pancreatic beta cells expressing human IPP or rodent IPP as control. As you can see here, in all conditions, IAPP interacts with P62. However, this interaction was increased in beta cells expressing amyloidogenic IAPP. We then investigated the role of P62 under increased expression of human IAPP expression and hypothesized that P62 buffers toxicity by forming inert intracellular inclusions. We previously reported that beta cells of human IPP transgenic mice contain large cytoplasmic P62 positive inclusions stained here in red. We thus investigated whether these inclusions could contain insoluble forms of IAPP. Since insoluble IAPP may form fibrils, we use the dye thioflavin S for staining. And we found that P62 inclusions were positive for thioflavin S in green. And this data suggests that IPP sequestered within these P62 inclusions is indeed organized into fibrils. as shown here by Hag magnifications. Interestingly, these inclusions were surrounded by the autophagy machinery involving autophagosome in red and lysosome in green for degradation. So, but what would be the consequences of the deficiency in autophagy? We thus hypothesize that concurrent loss of autophagy and increased human IPP expression leads to beta cell deterioration and diabetes. To test this hypothesis, we generated mice deficient for autophagy in beta cells with increased expression of human IAPP. By immunostaining, we detected an accumulation of toxic oligomers in beta cells of mice deficient in autophagy, and this might lead to diabetes development. Indeed, these mice had impaired fasting glucose by 12 to 13 weeks and then developed diabetes, characterized by beta cell deficiency, as you can see here, due to beta cell apoptosis, as quantified here, and at least in part to increased oxidative stress, as shown here by nitrotyrosine staining in red. In conclusion, we found that IAPP is ubiquitinated and targeted to lysosomal degradation by P62-dependent mechanism. Under condition of increased expression of human IAPP, P62 forms inert intracellular inclusions that may package toxic IAPP under fibrils to reduce its toxicity. If the autophagy machinery is available, this may target these packaged aggregates to degradation. However, in the context of defective autophagy, these inclusions become aggregates, ultimately leading to oxidative stress and beta cell deficit and type 2 diabetes. Our study is the first line of evidence establishing the protective role of the autophagy pathway against human IPP-induced beta cell toxicity. Moreover, this study implicates the autophagy players as key therapeutic targets for treatment and prevention of type 2 diabetes.